Here we are in our new greenhouse facilities of 7.3 hectares constructed by Nobakriek. Our main goal of our company is to cultivate a good quality tomato during 12 months per year.
Hemos desarrollado un módulo en una sola pieza que es el más grande de los construidos en España en los últimos años.
If we see that we can increase our production from 2022 till 2027, it is really improvement with the greenhouses that Nobakriek is constructing for us. I'm the general director of Loige Águilas SL, and in collaboration with my colleague Pedro Marin, we are the managers of the project of constructing this greenhouse. For many years, we have a collaboration with Nobakriek. We have weekly meetings with Nobakriek if they are fulfilling their deadlines, and we are making the global planification that we can plant on time the 3rd of August. Loige Águilas is originally a Dutch company. We have decided to go to Spain because of missing of sunlight in the winter times in Holland. We have a strategic plan till 2026. To fulfill the strategic plan, Loige Águilas has decided to build a greenhouse of 7.3 hectares. And in 2019, we have constructed the first greenhouse of this big project of 5 hectares. Also, Nobakriek has done this project. In 2021, we have decided to build a new greenhouse in 2022. So we have asked Nobakriek to make the project for us.
Estamos terminando este invernadero. Es un módulo de 7 hectáreas. Hemos optado por una construcción de alto volumen o de grandes dimensiones, tanto en altura como en anchura. Con estos grandes volúmenes de invernadero, lo que logramos es una climatización pasiva eficiente, de modo que el aire caliente se acumula en la parte superior de la estructura, dejando los niveles donde está el cultivo con una temperatura inferior.
If I construct 3 greenhouses, I need 3 organizations. And if I construct only a greenhouse of 7.3 hectares with 1 greenhouse, I only need 1 organization. Also, I only need to do the settings for the climate for 1 greenhouse. All these kinds of things are examples that it contributes to more efficiency.
En breve, esperamos continuar con la siguiente etapa. Se completaría el ciclo de más de 10 años trabajando con esta empresa y siempre en cada uno de los proyectos hemos hecho unas mejoras significativas en la estructura de manera que se pueda adecuar y alinearnos con los objetivos de productividad y calidad del cliente.
I have to say that I'm happy with the collaboration with Nobakriek. If I look to the last 6 months of the project, Nobakriek do what they say, they're fulfilling the deadlines, and they are always answering our question. We are cultivating 3 tomato sherry varieties, that is the Loose Sherry, the Baby Plum, and the Mini Tomato, which is a sherry brown product.
Para ello hemos diseñado una estructura lo más ligera posible, con parte de la estructura pintada en color blanco para que pueda reflejar la radiación del sol. Además, se dota de una ventilación perimetral doble, de manera que el aire caliente se pueda empujar hacia arriba con mayor rapidez y que la renovación de aire en el invernadero se produzca de un modo más efectivo.
The motors to open the plastic are inside. That means that gives less maintenance. With this system, the site is better closed. That means the possibility that the white fly will enter is less, which is also better for the sustainability because I use less products. And also in terms of cost, it will be better. This new greenhouse has a better water system. And that is what we also see in the quality of the product. In these greenhouses, we need to say that the quality is really good and really homogeneous over the greenhouse.
El sistema de cultivo es hidroponía de alto rendimiento con las plantas en sustrato suspendido todo ello de la propia estructura del invernadero.
Also in this greenhouse we have cultivation gutters and this has 3 advantages. Firstly, that the people are working more comfortable. The second one is that the productivity is higher. And the last one is that you will have less problems with the diseases because of the plants are not standing on the ground. Right now we are in our new greenhouses after 6 months harvesting our tomatoes. So the start was really good. We have planted on the 3rd of August and it's a really difficult day to plant because of the high temperatures here in Spain. I remember that we had temperatures of 41 degrees. Because of the high structure of the new greenhouse, it was possible to create a good climate for the new plant. In the summer, the temperatures are really high in Spain, but in winter time, the temperatures could be also really low. While it was possible to cultivate good quality tomatoes with the high temperatures in summertime, we have seen the last month that the coloration of the tomatoes was still really good. It was possible to maintain a constant climate in this greenhouse and to maintain the quality standards of our company. Till now, we have seen that the production is between 5 and 10% more than we have expected. We are really happy in this greenhouse and we are looking forward to the future.